Praise the Lord, brother. Just quick clarification. You know, you get caught up in the spirit, man. You start talking, and I misquoted myself because I've mentioned this before, so it's not like I'm changing it all of a sudden or something like that. I'm just, you know, making sure it's straight. You know, no line or word spoken that isn't the way it's supposed to be spoken. Now, what I made mention into a previous tape, I believe it was yesterday, I'm looking at this now this morning for the first time. I'm not sure. It might have been this morning. It's, you know, I don't pay attention to days and hours and times. Anyway, point I'm trying to make is, I mentioned something about the sons and daughters not being the trumpet. No. I've told you before in previous videos, they are the trumpet. What I was saying was that they are not the mouthpiece. So they would have not come into this in the way that I would, and I would be the forerunner of them because of that place that God has brought me into. You understand what I'm saying? So no, I've said before, I'm nothing more than the mouthpiece of which the Spirit, the Ruach, air, God speaks through. But the brothers, sons and daughters of God are the trumpet. They're the ones that go forth throughout this world, okay, and lead and come with the anointing of God upon them to gather in the wheat and send forth the army of Joel. Now, in the Holy Spirit ministry, you're going to see these things begin to take place. Now, you've got to understand, this is a very quick happening. And the Lord, he says, he comes as a thief in the night to them who are in the darkness, okay, to the children of darkness. It's like a thief in the night. Before they know it, it's over. Now, relative to the church and the tares that are in among the church, well, this may be drawn out, and because I have reason to believe, like I've said before, my hope is that we're, the natural Israel, the remnant, is gathered up with us and into the resurrection, all of us together. That being what it is, I also have the hope and belief that by the grace of God, the tares, the outer court, that there's a period of time for them to repent. Although they're not allowed to enter into the covering and the anointing of God, which protects us and covers us because we're on that bedrock that of the revealed word of God. We're standing upon that solid ground, which they are not because they refused to come in when they were supposed to, refused to lay down their swords, the divisions between these many members or these bodies out of 33,000. All of this is supposed to take place. Those that refuse it, I don't care if they claim the name of Jesus or they got a Holy Spirit gift they say they got, because I believe the Holy Spirit, like I told you, is removed before the ministry of the 11th hour. It's the end of the impart ministry. But, like I said, in the love of our Lord and our God, that even though they're not protected from the trampling upon the foot of men for the 42-month period and through the tribulation, they do go through it. They go through it. We go through it, but we're covered in the anointing. We're protected by God through the love feast of the brethren and everything that God is leading us into right now so that we're not affected by it. They are, because they won't stand together. They'll bite back at each other. They'll do all kinds of awful, terrible things just to protect their families and their friends. And so on and so forth, because they're a worldly church. You understand what I'm saying? But even of them, I'm hoping and praying that they have an opportunity to repent. Amen, Jesus? And this comes during that period of time when the evangelical footmen of natural Israel come forth. Okay? So that not only there is a remnant being gathered together up together with them, the remnant of natural Israel, this circumcised, those under the law, okay, but also any and all of them who have repented of not entering in, realize they did not get gathered together where they should have been now they come in under the covering of the brethren at that last hour. So I'm believing by faith that even though they're not a part of the first crew that's gathered together, which I believe, I don't know, I'm not sure about all that, how it all works out, and because the issues are going to become clearer as the water, the crystal, the streets, they're pure glass. The path that we walk on is clear glass. It's the fullness of the revelation. So that we're not like what I am right now, just on the peripherals of the vision, of the understanding. We come in under the anointing in the fullness of that, of which, like I said, like a crescendo of music grows and grows and grows into the brightness and the fullness of that day. Boom. Done. Out of here. Gone. History. Well, we're in the cause with the Lord. I believe we'll return and we're a part of that group. Because like I said before, I have had a dream regarding being lifted up in the air. Okay, the natural man. Well, he probably, but right in the process, because I have a little fear of heights and stuff. It's just the Lord looking out for me, you know what I mean? And all of us, okay, because he's going to do the same for everybody. Just as we start to rise up, those of you that have a little fear of heights, it's going to be